All right, we're back here to the second part of this install video, and I restarted my computer. It took a little while to go through and have setup load things, and we are back here to this page that we're installing 10 of 10 right now, and it is still going about doing its thing. I'm going to pause the recording once again, and we'll come back to it when we need to. All right, I'm back. I've come up with an error message here that I'm not really sure exactly what this means, but it says it could not download the Microsoft Windows Installer 4.5, or it could not install the Microsoft SQL Server. I don't know that that's going to affect what we're going to do, but we'll find out. I'm not going to send my error report, and I'm going to exit. Notice here I have this add desktop shortcut to set up to install these components later. I'm not going to do that because I don't think we're going to need that desktop shortcut to install those components. I don't know if that's going to happen with you when you go through your setup. Each computer is kind of different a little bit, and that's what happened with mine. So I'm going to hit exit. See what happens. That's my son Josiah there, by the way, on my background. I'm going to now go to my start menu, and all programs. And you'll notice here I have an icon for Visual Basic 2008 Express Edition. I'm going to start it up and we'll see what happens. My recording window is going to be smaller than what the window is, but that's okay. We'll see what happens when we go through and let this thing run. I'm going to pause it again while my computer is thinking. All right, so Visual Basic is here, and it looks like everything is okay. This is the page that you're going to start off with, your start page. And right now you can go through and kind of video feature tour, learn VB, kind of look through those things if you choose. I'm going to go to create a project, and let's see, Windows Form Applications, that's what we're going to be looking at, just so you get an idea of what this looks like. And we'll be working through this more for how do you move around and how do you create a project and all of that. We'll be creating some videos for you to do that. So you'll notice things are not real fast. At times Visual Basic is a very memory intensive program. So this is what we get right now at the beginning of Visual Basic, and we'll talk about what this means to have a form. And you'll notice over here to the left a little bit, we've got a toolbox. We'll be talking about all of those different things later on and how this works. But it looks like I had an error in my install, but things appear to be working correctly for me. I think I'll stop with this for now. We'll come back at a later point, and we'll create some videos for what all this means, how to create your own form, how to add different buttons and tools to the form, what this means, the Solution Explorer, how to move around, how to deal with the properties window. There's a lot of stuff to learn just in how this is set up and how to access all of your different things. So I will sign off for now and talk to you later.